So this vehicle we're looking at here is BMP-1. It was a radical design of the 1970s by the Soviet Union. Why radical at the time? Because in most NATO countries, we were used to the idea of an armoured personnel carrier, think 432, something like that, just being a battle taxi, delivering the infantry to where they're needed on the battlefield. With BMP-1, things changed. This became an IFV, an infantry fighting vehicle. Why? Because if we look down the side here, section of six infantry in the back, we're giving them gun ports so that they can fire the AK-47 out of the side. Relatively thin armour, but again, for this idea of delivering a section of troops, quite a bit of firepower. Not only their firepower, but we have a cannon on it and also a launch rail for a SAGA missile. And a SAGA missile can potentially take out a tank. So that alarmed NATO at the time. Subsequently, with these vehicles, we've had BMP-2, we've had BMP-3 come along as well. They've had more firepower, as with so many vehicles, new sighting systems, extra sophistication. We're seeing all of those variants, 1, 2, and 3, being operated in the Ukraine at the moment by both sides. So it's another one of those vehicles where it can be quite confusing, and that's why often in the Ukraine, you'll see both sides as well, trying desperately to make sure their vehicle is identified. With the Russians, obviously, that Z on the side, with the Ukrainians, quite often you'll see a colour of the day or the Ukrainian flag being flown if they're going into battle situations, just so we don't have the blue on blue type of situations that every army is trying to avoid.